Hello, Dr. Brian Halsabus here, and welcome to another edition of Ask the Chiropractor. Ask the Chiropractor is my little podcast where people come on and they ask a question about chiropractic. And whenever you have a question about chiropractic or chiropractic care, I always recommend you ask a chiropractor. So don't ask your family doctor, don't ask a dentist, don't ask a podiatrist, don't ask a physical therapist, ask a chiropractor about chiropractic. And so I'm a graduate of Palmer College of Chiropractic. I'm the official team chiropractor of the Rockford IceHogs, and I'm a very active member of the International Chiropractic Association. So today, to Ask the Chiropractor, we're gonna do a little bit different format today. Instead of me answering a question about chiropractic, I'm gonna try to address a thing I saw on the internet with a couple of frequently asked questions about chiropractic. I'm gonna break them each down real quick, one by one. But if you want more on any one of these topics, if you go to our website, RockfordDC, RockfordDC.com, and you hit the blogs and you do a search, you can find much more information on all of these topics where I talked about each one of them individually. But today we're gonna do a couple of quick ones, and I'm gonna try to answer these frequently asked questions about chiropractic. So if you know someone who's been thinking about going to chiropractic care, I might have a couple of questions. I'm gonna read them out. First one, what should I go to the chiropractor for? How do I know it's time for me to go to a chiropractor? Well, a lot of times we don't know the answer to this, because a lot of times I'll take someone's x-rays and we'll find out we should have met them a long time ago because they've got arthritic changes to their spine. But let me do the best I can to this answer. Basically, this chiropractic is about how the spine moves, how the spine turns, how the spine functions. So if you're starting to feel limitations on your range of motion, like I can look a lot really far to the left and not so far the other way, that would be a reason to maybe go see a chiropractor. A thing I do a lot of times is I have people back up against the mirror. When they're against the mirror, I tell them to stand casual. I'll take a dry eraser marker and mark above each ear, each shoulder, each hip, and maybe in each armpit. If those lines are not straight across, then there's some twisting and turning in that spine. A lot of times too, if you're noticing that someone's gait or the way they walk or the way they step is starting to change, that could be clues that the spine's not moving biomechanically. But the number one reason why people come to see us, and unfortunately it's a sad answer, but it's the real answer. I tried everything else. I have a good friend that won't leave me alone. They really think I should come in and try the chiropractor. That's the real reason why most people first come in the first time. So I hope those are little clues that help to help you out more. And again, if you want more, we did videos on this. Is chiropractic safe? Someone told me if I go with a chiropractor, they could turn my neck the wrong way and paralyze me, or chiropractic adjustments can cause a stroke and I'll have major problems. These are always funny to me because I'll give you the simple, quickest answer. Is chiropractic safe? Chiropractors have the lowest malpractice insurance rates of anybody. Nobody does more research to see if somebody's safe or not safe than an insurance company. Think about when you were 16 years old driving a car. You were high risk, you had high insurance rates. So if chiropractors cause lots of problems, if chiropractors were filing malpractice lawsuits all the time and injuring people and getting sued all the time, surely we would not have the lowest malpractice rates of anybody. But chiropractors have the lowest malpractice rates of anybody. Are you safe here? Absolutely. How do we know you're safe? Well, we do full exam, x-rays, and everything else that we can here in the office to make sure that you're safe and cleared. We also attend many, 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 many years of college and get professional training. So if you were coming in and you were having a vascular compromise in your neck, most chiropractors would recognize that and they would not proceed with care until you were checked out. So are you safe at a chiropractic clinic? Yeah, chiropractic adjustment's pretty darn safe. Not everyone's perfect, and not every chiropractor's good, not every dentist is good, not every family doctor's good, but for the most part, chiropractors are safe. Again, our malpractice rates speak volumes for that. Next, can children benefit from chiropractic care? Absolutely. A lot of insurance companies have this crazy notion that kids can't hurt their backs, and all you have to do is go to YouTube and type in kids and wipeouts or kids and crashes. And you have to remember back, like when I was a kid, we had a half pipe skateboard in our skateboard ramp in our front yard. It was 10 feet tall, 20 foot wide. It's a pretty good thing my dad's a chiropractor because we absolutely needed him. We would fall wipe out all the time, or fall on our bicycles and crash our bikes, or fall out of the treehouse, or, you know, not only that, but, you know, I grew up next to three brothers, so we were quite common to get some pretty heavy wrestling and matches, not professional or organized wrestling matches, just Saturday night, boys being boys, crazy wrestling matches with the three brothers next door and a couple other, two other guys down the street. That was real common. So, you know, I always tease that most of my injuries didn't come from football. They came from playing with the guys on the street for me. So yeah, the kids need chiropractors, absolutely. Did we do things different with kids? Absolutely. Depending on how old and young they are, we change the way we take care of them. And I go to that great, great detail in other podcasts. So go ahead and take a listen to some of the other podcasts if you have questions about chiropractic care for kids and some of the special training. Next question. How many times do I have to go for my condition to the chiropractor? We get people all the time that call us up and they say, I have right side sciatica. Before I come in, I want to know exactly how many times I'm coming. Call your dentist up sometime, tell your dentist, hey, I haven't brushed my teeth in 3 years. I want to know how many times I have to come in for cleanings. They don't know until they see you and they examine you. And the same here is true for the chiropractor. If we take your x-rays, you have all kinds of degeneration, arthritis, and you're just so toxic and chemical, physical and emotional stress, it's going to take a ton to get you better. But if you come in and you're healthy, you exercise, and your spine looks nice and strong and healthy, your disc spaces look good, there's no arthritis, you don't need as much care as somebody with more degenerative changes. So how long does it come in? Well, that's something you need to look at your chiropractor. Not every patient should have the exact same care plan. It should be custom tailored to you. If you find out the chiropractor is telling everyone the exact same thing, then I raise an eyebrow at that. It's pretty weird that every patient comes in needs the exact same amount of care. So as chiropractors, it's our job to look at your spine, see how you respond to care, see how much your body's receptive to the change, and then we have to come up with a care plan that meets your needs. So if you go to a chiropractor and everyone's the same, I raise an eyebrow at that. But if you come to the chiropractor and they make a unique care plan directly for you, then that's what it takes. And it's okay to have these conversations with the chiropractor. You know, we also here teach you the things that you can do to speed it up, right? Do this stretch, do this, don't do this, do more of this, don't sit too long, do this and this and this. We'll give you clues to make it go faster. That's part of our job. Next question. What can chiropractors treat? What can chiropractors treat? Well, chiropractors only treat one thing. That's the cool thing, right? We treat the spine. When the spine's misaligned, our job is to free it up so it can go back to where it's supposed to be and heal, and the nerve energy come back out the way it's supposed to. That's all we do. Just the spine, let the spine take care of itself. So we're at a chiropractor's treat. We treat one thing and one thing only. We call them subluxations. Spine's misaligned, stress is kicking out, the nerve carries that stress, goes to body parts then go into a stress response. We give you adjustments, those things heal up. So we can treat the spine, we adjust the spine, we correct subluxations. Now subluxations clear up, what gets better? Anything that has a nerve going to it, if that's the problem. I'll talk about heartburn real quick. Two types of heartburn, right? The heartburn that maybe your T6 is misaligned and the nerve coming out, your T6 going to your stomach isn't properly working. When you eat food, your body doesn't know how to properly digest it because of the stress coming from your T6 to your stomach. Therefore, you overproduce your stomach acid because your body's confused on how much to make because of the nerve interference. We adjust that, get that back in. The catecholamines, the type 4 mechanical receptors stop coming out. The stress response when the nerve goes away and the heartburn clears up. That's a chiropractic case right there for you. We didn't treat the heartburn, we treated the problem at T6. However, if you go eat a double bacon cheeseburger with French fries with cheese on top of them and a large chocolate milkshake to wash it down, that's heartburn you earn. That's heartburn you deserve. That's nothing we can do for that. So again, you can go back and look and see this. I talk about this all the time in different videos, do a deeper dive. And the last frequently asked question on this, according to this page, is can a woman who's pregnant come in and see the chiropractor? And that's an absolutely yes, absolutely. As chiropractors, we learn a special technique called the Webster technique, W-E-B-S-T-E-R. The Webster technique is designed for pregnant women. It's also really helpful for breech babies. So if you know someone's pregnant, has a breech baby, find a chiropractor that does the Webster technique and go see them. Yeah, so we get special treatment in taking care of pregnant women. Take care of tons of pregnant women over the years. Lots and lots and lots and lots of pregnant women. And there's all kinds of research on this because in order to get certified in pediatrics, you have to write a paper. Hundreds and thousands of chiropractors have done their certification, and there's all kinds of journals and periodicals on taking care of pregnant women and kids. So if you're like me and you want to read the science first, take a look at the science first, go for it. But yeah, can chiropractors take care of pregnant women? Absolutely. And again, I've dived into this topic so deep in other podcasts. Go back, look at the other podcasts, look at the previous history on this page. You'll see tons and tons of chiropractic podcasts I've done about pregnant women and newborns and stuff like that. So there you got it. A couple of quick frequently asked questions from the chiropractor. So this week's Ask the Chiropractor, a little bit different. We dove into a whole bunch of little questions, little topics, not deep dives, but just quick answers. And again, all these questions are answered in much more depth in previous podcasts. Go take a listen. rockfordc.com. Hit the blog page, or if you're watching us on Facebook or YouTube, subscribe to our channel. You'll see all the videos we've done over the years. And then if you're on LinkedIn, it's there too. I mean, it's everywhere. So you'll find us. You'll find the other topics. All right, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the frequently asked questions. I'm going to be hanging out at the college again. Next week might even be more fun because I'll be at the school. Maybe I'll sit down with one of my professors. Who knows? Other than that, everybody stay healthy, stay strong, and we'll talk to you next time. And if you have a question for Ask the Chiropractor, submit it, and maybe next week you'll be the question of the week. Thank you.